Okay. In this video, we are going to understand about the problem of choice in an economy. Now, what do you mean by problem of choice? The first important question. Now, let's look for a moment. Society needs for goods and services unlimited. Now, this is a very important concept which not only applies to a society, but also to an individual. It's equally applicable to you and me as individuals, whether you are a student, you are a house runner, maybe your father, your mother. Similarly, any city, town, village, company, country. Now, what happens is that at any given point in time, the needs that an individual has, and please mind that individuals are the ones who make up for the society, are different. The needs are different. When I say different, what do I mean? You need to have a good transport. You would really want to have the best of the cars, food. You want to eat at the best of the joints, be it the McDonald's, Subway, or any other. Clothing. You want to wear the best of the brands. You want to have as many clothes as possible. Gadgets. You want to have the consoles. You want to have mobile phones. You want to have everything. Doctors, lawyers. You want to consult the best of the doctor for any health related matter. Shelter. You want to have the best of the house in the best of the locality. So each of an individual has different needs, and these needs are unlimited. Now, if you have one car, you will say, why not have one more? Or why not have one more? Now, when you have all these cars, you will say, okay, today I have an X brand. Why not go for a premium brand Y? And so on. So what will happen is that one, you have different needs. And two, within these needs, these keep on changing. But what happens is that while you may want all of these, the best of these, the fact of the life is your income of family is limited. So therefore comes the question of choice. If I take a home in best of the localities, by best of the builders, I have to pay the EMI. Suppose my income is 100 and I pay 50 as EMI, that I only have 50 to spend on the balance things. So therefore, I have to make a choice. Should I go for a better housing? Again, if you take a car, you have to pay the EMI. But if you pay your most of the incomes, let's say you spend 20 on the EMI of the car. So you're left only with 30. Now at this 30, you have to take care of the food. You have to take care of the clothing. You have to take care of your gadgets and everything else. So therefore, it's a matter of adjustment for an individual family. Now just like that, when you look for the society, let's say India. Now India has a lot of people. Today, as we speak, we are a 1.2 billion population, right? So these 1.2 billion people, you know, you have to make a choice as to whether as a country I want to concentrate on manufacturing or service, or what do I do? We have land which can be cultivated. Let's say in India you have land. This land can be used to build multiplexes. This land can be used for cultivation. This land can be used for education and so on. So it's a matter of choice. This land, although, is limited. You don't have unlimited land. So the use are multiple. So you have to make a choice. So the needs are unlimited. I mean, Everyone would want to have a 1,000 square yard house. But the needs are unlimited. So 1.2 billion people, everyone has his own needs. The needs are unlimited. The resources of the society, let's stay in my example, land, to satisfy these needs are limited. And therefore, you have to make a choice as to where do you want to apply this land to. You want to build a multiplex, right? You want to use it for cultivation. You want to use it for setting up educational institution. That's the choice that any country has to make. So the problem of choice is very important and it's all pervasive. Now, because of this limited needs, choice is all pervasive, which means that choice is all important. Because the needs are limited, these are unlimited needs, plus limited resources result in the question of choice. So choice to have a better housing, if you spend 50 on housing, your 100 out of your 100 income, you're left only with the balance 50. Choice to have better education, choice to have a car or a TV, and so on. So the choice is one of the most important aspects which governs an economy and a society.